connected to this thing?
Should be. We're going live.
Hey!
Hey! Hello out there. My name is Matty, and this is Charity.
How's it going?
We are two members of a group called The Head and the Heart. And we were asked by American Songwriter to come and do a handful of songs and talk about them. And we were ecstatic to be able to do that as we were sort of sitting here. Hey, American Songwriter. Hi, guys. we were sort of sitting here twiddling our thumbs like everyone else in the world right now. And this is a good opportunity to kind of touch some songs that we hadn't touched in a long time and figure out, you know.
Play some B-sides, even some unreleased songs from The Head and the Heart. And we're also, for those of you who can and feel, you know, led to donate, we're also supporting a really great cause during this kind of stay-at-home performance, and it's for Newport Festival's Musician Relief Fund, and it supports artists and musicians who are affected by the crisis. And so if you've ever been touched by music, it's a very powerfully healing thing, and you're able to, that's a great cause. So
yeah.
We don't do this all the time. We rarely do this. So thanks so much to American Songwriter for asking us. And hopefully it sounds good. This is coming to everyone from our house in Seattle. And
we've got some tunes for you guys. We are going to start with a song that Charity wrote during the making of the Let's Be Still record, right?
It was technically Let's Be Still, yeah.
And
when we were recording.
And you kind of, as I recall, it was sort of towards the end of making the record when you sort of put it together. And there's a band demo, which is great, but then...
Pretty loose, but yeah.
But it wasn't quite dialed in enough to make the record at the time. Mm-hmm. But you had it in the back of your head and everyone really loved the song. And then it came down the pike somehow. I don't remember how, but that Mavis Staples was making a record, and M. Ward was producing it, and he was looking for people to write the songs, write some songs for it, and so of course you would jump at the opportunity to do that, right? And sorry, I'm talking for you, but there's a question on here that says, how did this song end up in the hands of Mavis Staples? Do you want to talk about that?
Yeah, Well, real briefly, I mean, Mavis's camp. Mavis is amazing, first of all, and she's a huge inspiration for me personally. And so when her camp reached out to us and through our management saying that, you know, she's looking at doing an album and she's looking for artists and Ward's producing, we all got on the phone. I mean, it was a complete no-brainer, and we called and talked to Mavis Staples on the phone. And she was just kind of talking about how she was kind of had reached a point kind of where she was at, kind of done writing sad songs, and she wanted to write songs of joy and hope. And I started I kind of virtually connected with her over the phone, but when she was kind of talking kind of in depth about kind of her observations of things, you know, that she's, you know, kind of observed throughout her life, and a lot of division and wanting to write songs about hope and coming together, I just started to get teary-eyed and knew this song that I'd written, you know, like 6 months ago in my back pocket, If It's a Light would be the song. And sure enough, we sent it over, and her and she and M. Ward really, really liked it, and so it's on this amazing kind of album. And also shout out to Mavis and her camp for, she's this, you know, like, career that spans years and genres, and she's really kind of been involved in reaching out to younger songwriters, and so that whole album is just filled with a lot of us kind of from different genres and kind of
There's songs by Toon Yards, M Ward, Bon Iver, John Batiste, Nico Case is on there. There's a lot of other great writers. Ben Harper.
Great company.
It's a cool record. Came out in 2016.
And this is just, that was kind of a unique opportunity. It's a unique song, and it's called If It's a Light.
If it's a light, then let it go. Don't let it fall, don't let it stumble. We've been down this road before. Seen too much now to ignore. Come away from the darkness, darling. Step back into the light again. If you call my name, then I will come. Don't let the wildness of time cloud your view. We'll keep walking this road, me and you. Come away from the darkness, darling. Step back into the light again. If you call my name, then I will come.
Guys,
Is it sounding all right to everybody?
We have no way of knowing. I guess there's comments, but we can't read them.
We're just going as if this is everything's working.
That's such a fun song, Charity Rose. You did a great job on that one.
Thanks.
What do we got next?
Partisan.
Right. So this. What inspired you to write this song, Jerry? This is a question.
So this is actually...
I guess you didn't know.
This is another kind of interesting song that landed... It's an unreleased Head in the Heart song. And it was... We got the call from this independent filmmaker about a film that he was writing. This song was, after watching the film kind of with placeholder music or unfinalized score, I wrote this song kind of inspired by this pretty beautiful story about this young person who kind of was creating adventure in the midst of knowing that she had terminal cancer, and which I think that there's actually some, we wrote another song for it, and there's a little, some confusion whether or not that's, that the film has actually is out, or if the songs were ended up being placed in it. But this is a song that, you know, like, took inspiration from that, and it was a really cool process. And I see there's a question, when do you plan to release the song? Well, the band is talking, kind of creatively brainstorming about some tunes that we could maybe release and compile together in the near future, in the relatively near future.
Yeah, it's a really fun one. I really love it. We got to record a version of it, like you said, for the soundtrack, with everybody involved, and it was one of the funnest, just freewheeling sessions that I've been a part of since I've been in the band with you guys. Really fun.
And there's a really fun, like, on the, like, final mix of it, there's this kind of, like, wood blocks, galloping wood blocks, and I was kind of oddly inspired by kind of like spaghetti westerns. So in a weird way that kind of found its way into this, but in this acoustic version you'll feel a little bit of gallop.
Yeah, imagine some clip clop clomp clomp wood blocks happening right now.
Remember that midnight noon when we met, your gaze upon me, those partisan eyes made me look to the plains and the stars where there are sightless streets, dancing weeds, few things are there. I see you up there, I see you above, dream with my eyes open, but it still ain't enough. Hope you're doing well, hope nothing has changed, 'cause down here there are few things alive. You make the rules, you bend the time, you be a good ghost to haunt me, you good friend to want me, you are a good friend of mine. You make earth boring, you make my mornings, you win some, you lose some. We made a great story. I'll see you in the tomorrows. I'll see you again. I'll see you in the tomorrows. I'll see you again. You make the rules, you bend the time, you be a good ghost to haunt me, a good friend to warn me, you are a good friend of mine. It's hard to get rid of this pain that I've hidden, the time we were given would make even the same man
as soon as something says L-I-V-E, you just mess up the last chord of the song, which is the easiest part.
That's just how it goes. The song's not released yet, so people just can assume it, though.
Yeah, it goes to a dissonant E8.
This next song is a song... do you want to put that down?
Yeah. Cool.
This is a song that I wrote for a batch of songs that I was writing on the... Right before I got the call to actually join Head in the Heart, I had recorded a bunch of songs with my brother, and close friend Navid Elliott, who is a songwriter as well from a band called Planes on Paper and Bodies on the Beach are his two projects. And then Faustine Hudson, who is ironically now, she's a great drummer, incredible drummer, and she's ironically drumming for Josiah now. So and she was in that band that I kind of, but batch of tunes that I had to kind of put on the side for a while. But anyways, this is a love song from that batch called Love Take Two. When the lights went down and we planted our two timid bodies upon that patch of ground, in our makeshift bed, where visions of the future form like crystals there in our heads, and the scars that we compare weren't enough to make a mark, they disappeared right there and carried off into thin air, and all that remained was just the laughter that we shared. To die down here. this next song is a song, another as yet unreleased, but will be soon. Apologies to anyone who tuned into this hoping to hear greatest hits. That's very much not what we're doing right now. but these are.
Although we're going to get to some,
we'll get to some
more
though, yeah.
Some choicier cuts, but yeah. But this is
It's an opportunity to play some different stuff, and why not?
It's the best.
We're in our living room, so for those of you just joining, my name is Matty, and this is Charity. We play in a band called The Head and the Heart, and we're going to do a song called Wandering Albatross. Do you want to talk about this song? Charity wrote it.
To the questions. We got some questions about these tunes.
Can you tell us more about the writing experience for the song?
So the song, so the band, went to a place in Stinson Beach, California, when we were writing Signs of Light, kind of demoing. And every morning I would go out, I mean, it was just naturally so, so beautiful up there. And so it was really inspiring to kind of just do morning pages. And it was just the flora and fauna, you know, was so different than where I'm from in the Northwest. And, you know, I remember seeing like a condor for the first time, and California condor and sedums, and, you know, kind of the arid, kind of more deserty terrain, you know, was inspiring and found its way into lyrics in this song. And yeah, it was a really kind of inspired song, I would say.
I remember being super excited when I first heard the demo. She sent me the demo. Just loved it immediately. I was like, what is going on down there? Keep doing more of that. Such a good, fun song.
Mysterious. It's super fun.
Fun's maybe the wrong word. Mysterious. Okay, I might need to get up here. So.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Maybe just angle or something like that.
Yeah.
Cool. Sorry. All right. It's tight quarters in here, everybody. All righty. Here we go. This is Wandering Albatross.
My wandering
All right.
Thank you.
That was Wandering Albatross.
In case you're wondering.
In case you were some wondering albatrosses out there. This is a song that we put out recently that we were very lucky and very thankful to be a part of the Alzheimer's Association's musical moments compilation that just got put out. We were one of many artists who got to contribute a song that sort of meant something to them, meant something to the artist regarding their relationship with Alzheimer's disease and how music can connect us to our moments in life, and how it was my experience with my grandfather going through it that no matter how far he got along the path, he really, he never could forget a song, and he would always have music in his heart, and he would always be singing, and whenever he was singing, he would be the same as he ever was and be happy, and that was really what brought us together as younger people and aspiring musicians at the time. And so he taught us a lot about jazz, and he was a huge jazz cat. He was a saxophone player, and so it was really great to be able to put out a song that that was a part of this whole thing. The song is called Backwards Breathing, and it goes out to Brandon if you're watching. Here goes. Two. Let's find the key first. Two, three, four.
Don't have to pretend. Still out of bed, you're not off the hook, you're no longer required.
looking for on that last
good
chord.
Good sharp. Yeah.
Remix. Just a subtle remix.
So that was Backwards Breathing, everybody. That one goes out to you, Brandon, if you're watching. We have a couple more songs for you guys. Thank you so much. This has been really fun. Thank you to American Songwriter for asking us to be a part of it. I hope we've done okay. If we haven't, let us know ways in which we can improve, and we will do better next time.
Invisibly so.
Or maybe one of the ways we could improve happened to involve Charity playing harmonica, in which case, we're going to go ahead and hit you with that right now. This is a song, another song of mine written right before I was asked to join Head and the Heart. These are songs that were special to me, and I think people who are fans of Head and the Heart may enjoy, hopefully.
I love this song.
There's a question, what does this side project mean to you? For me, it didn't begin as a side project whatsoever. I've been a lifelong songwriter. This was just the most recent batch of songs that I put together. It was something like 17 songs that we released under the name Shallow Lenses, sort of somewhat unceremoniously last year or the year before. And so for me, the difference is no different than anything as far as my relationship to music goes in general. I just, I've got the bug and I keep writing songs.
I remember, I remember hearing this song actually at this piano in our living room, and I was upstairs and you were playing it, and it just like it gave me goosebumps, and I knew, I was like, this song, we have to work on this song. And you know, I was really inspired by it, and you know, it's a good one. And it,
she's my barometer, so if Charity perks up, that means it's at least halfway decent. So this one's called Take It to the Table. Starring Charity on
her. Yeah, America. This is a.
All right. One, two, three, four. There's nothing you can do. Silly little world, but get a piece of property and rearrange it. Take it to the table and make somebody love you and find someone who knows that everything is changing and that's just the way it goes. There's nothing you can do in this silly little world. Find yourself a good job and try to make it work. Start a little family and build a little house. I know it isn't easy, but it's what it's all about. Nothing you can do in this silly little world, but give up everything that you ever wanted and take it to the table and bet it all on black. Though you won't be able to ever get it back. Oh, All right. We made it. That one, thank you. All In From Any Originals. Thank you, Jacob Murdoch.
Thanks, Jacob Murdoch.
This next tune is the last tune we're going to play. Actually, yeah, just a quick note for that last song, for since we're on American Songwriter, one of the goals of that song for me was to write a song with only two chords and have it go places, just as like a challenge. And that was like exciting and fun to like intentionally find a lot of places to go musically and play with dynamics and melody.
Intention.
Yeah, with as few chords as possible. Mm-hmm. So that's fun. Another song, a song off of the most recent Head in the Heart album that does that too, to great effect, I think, is Living Mirage. The song oscillates back and forth between it. Same two chords, actually. That's why the same harmonica works. it's not the exact same harmonica that Chris uses. That would not be good in the modern era.
Wash your hands, wash your harmonicas.
Anyways, thank you guys so much for being out there and tuning in and watching, and thank
being
you
present.
Again to American Songwriter for being what now?
Being present.
All right.
You know, I feel like in this era, it's the importance of being present. You know, it's a thing. I feel like it's good to be feeling where you are, knowing where you are, and being intentional and purposeful, you know, when the days seem to blur for a lot of us, and even especially those on the front lines. I just want to give a shout out to everyone who is working in some capacity on the front lines and kind of aspiring to create some kind of normalcy for the rest of us who, you know, like, we're fighting this war by staying home. And so yeah, shout out to y'all. Thank you so genuinely. And and I lastly also wanted to give love and peace, send that to the families of two amazing songwriters who we lost within the span of a handful of days, Mr. John Prine and also Bill Withers. And they're some of the greats of writing songs and singing them, and they will continue to inspire those of us who write and aspire to write as they do. And so check out their canons and honor them by listening to Bill Withers and John Prine this week. And anyway, thank you all so much. I'm rambling.
No, that was good rambles, though, important rambles. We were listening to a bunch of John Prine last night, and watching the full moon. It was a pink moon. It was a very eerie and beautiful night. World's gonna miss him, but we have his tunes. So it was good. This one goes out to everybody feeling the loss of many different kinds that we're all feeling right now. Much love to everybody. This one's written by Charity. It's called Library Magic.
Drawing to that sort of library magic, whispering through the dusty aisles, watching all the thinkers read, trying to keep a grown man quiet like pulling teeth on a winter's eve. Cracks and poles and unfamiliar roads, I'm on this one to find out. Bertie Guest and Brother Surratt can't stay healthy in a cloud of eyes, listening to my every move, just trying to survive. The self-imposed adventures that selfishness drives, I can barely keep my head above the blue, trying to keep it all for me and you. But I can see the sunshine's rays gleaming through the clear water, telling me you gotta hop in for this chapter's right. There will always be better days. There will always be better days. Making music is what we do. Trying to weave the patterns for me new. Trying to make the grasses breathe and a grown man cry. Truth and life is where I gleam. Just tangled up in the funnel's winds. Trying to come out walking. Understand it's beyond me talking. I'm trying to come out walking. Understand it's beyond me talking. But I can see the sunshine's rays gleaming through the clear water. Telling me you gotta hop in for this chapter's right. But there will always be better days. There will always be better days. Being alone isn't lonely. It's sought after like a holiday. Being home is my vacation. Postcard dreams of a full-size bed. Quit the band one too many times. Serious enough to get a rise. But he'll hop in the next morning for another drive. That's the promise, the best advice we ever received is for you and me to stay here together. It's easy to begin and hard to end. But I'm just glad to go through it all with you as friends. And I can see the sunshine's rays gleaming through the clear water. Telling me you gotta hop in for this chapter's ride. There will always be better days. There will always be better days. There will always be better days.
Thank you so much. Thank you all very, very much for being with us. Yeah. There will always be better days. And sending love and peace to everybody where they're at. Thank you all so much.